Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Coding with T. Today we are going to learn how to set up Firebase in our Flutter application. We are not going to use the old method in which we have to download the files and upload in the root directory. We don't know the current status, what's going on. We just have to go through the five basic steps and our application will be connected. So before starting today's tutorial, those who are new, we are creating a Flutter login application and our design is completed. As you can see, the design portion is completed. But today we are officially going to start the backend portion. You can get the design from the description below and also the playlist link from the description below to watch previous as well as upcoming videos. And if you're new, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about the latest videos. And as the backend, you can see we are going to set up our Flutter project today. Then we will learn all these things step by step. So let's start with today's tutorial. You can see we need these steps to set up our Flutter Firebase project. First, we have to create the Flutter project. Then we have to install the Firebase CLI. Using the CLI, we will log in to our Firebase. Then we are going to activate that Flutter CLI that we have downloaded, and then we are going to run the Flutter Fire configure command. These are the few commands that we have to run, and at the end we are going to add the dependency in our project and we are good to go. So let's get started. Well, the first step is to create the Flutter Firebase project. So first of all, you have to open the firebase.google.com. Click on go to console. In here we have to add a new project. So click add project. Name your project, click continue, and in here if you need Google Analytics for the basic purpose, we don't need it, and for the professional application if you are going to use the Google Analytics, then it must be selected, otherwise we don't need it. Create project. So project is created, click continue. Okay, now we have to add the Firebase to our application. So for that we have iOS, Android and web, Unity and Flutter. So we are going to set up it for Flutter. So click over here. Now you can see the first thing is the CLI, which is our second step. So let's click it, open it in a new tab. Okay, to set up the Firebase CLI, you have to select your options. I am using Windows. And in here, you can choose standalone binary, which is a .exe. This is actually causing issues in setup. And I got many questions about that. This standalone binary is not working. So this is basically a .exe file. You can download it from here. But we are going to use the npm, which is recommended. So for that, we just need to add node.js to run this command. So click on node.js, open it a new tab, download this recommended for most users. So once the file is downloaded, you can see over here, you just have to run it and install the node.js. Okay, once the node.js has been downloaded and installed, just copy this command, which is to install the Firebase tools. Open any command prompt or shell. Just run this command, hit enter. So in here you can see change 657 packages and audited with the 658 packages in 1 minute. So once it's done, minimize it. We can close the CLI. And the next step is we have to run the Firebase login. Okay, open the command prompt again. Paste the Firebase login, hit enter. And it's going to ask you that it want to collect CLI and emulator suit usage, reporting error. If you want to allow, then enter the Y. Otherwise, I'm not going to allow. Hit. So enter N for now. Hit enter. It's going to pop up a new screen and asking you to choose an account. So you can choose your account. Just make sure that this is the same account from where we have created our Firebase project. Click allow. And you can see Firebase CLI login successful. Close the window and back over here and you can see successfully login. Okay, after that we have to install the Flutter SDK, which is already installed. If you still have not installed the Flutter SDK, you can watch the video. Link is in the description to install Flutter. And also I am considering that the Flutter project is created. If not, you can again watch the previous video. Click next. Then once we are logged in, we have to activate the Flutter CLI. Copy this command. Again, open the command prompt. And now we have to activate Flutter Fire CLI, hit enter. Once done, you can see installed executable Flutter Fire and activated Flutter Fire CLI, and this is its version. So now we have activated our Flutter Fire CLI. Okay, and here one more thing, that if you get any warning related to pub installs executable into some specific path, and then you can fix that by adding that directory into your system's path environment variable, then you can easily configure it using press the Windows button to open the start menu or open search. You just have to write env for the environment variables or write environment variables. Click on this. The system properties will be appeared inside the advanced module. Click on environment variables. In here you can see we already have a path created. If not, you can click on new, name it path, and you have to paste the path that was appeared inside the command prompt. I have already a path created. So if already path is created, click on edit. And inside this was the path that I have to paste. You just have to click on new, paste the path, click OK. Again, click OK and that's it. That error will be gone. Well, now there are two ways to configure this project. You can see it is saying that you have to go towards the root of your Flutter project directory and run this command. We cannot run this command globally, but we have to go to the root of your project and we can run this command. So there are two ways. I'm going to show you both. So you just have to copy Flutter file configure, copy it, open the project we are already working on, login Flutter application, and you can get the same design from description below. And in here you just have to open the terminal and you can see we are pointing towards our current project, and in here we are going to run the command which is Flutter Fire configure. We are already logged in and hit enter, and you can see it's fetching available Firebase projects, and these are the bunch of projects that I have created in this Gmail account that I have connected. You can use the down arrow or up arrow to select the projects. So we have the Flutter login application project, hit enter, and then you can want to, if you want to choose any other platform, Android and iOS by default selected because it's a Flutter, you can use the space bar to select and unselect any of the option. So I'm going for the Android and iOS, hit enter. Again, here you can see it's saying that registered a new Firebase Android app on Firebase project. So this was the ID. Open the browser and you can see it was previously saying Flutter Fire configure. We can directly run this command, which is again Flutter login app, and this is the project ID. So it have automatically created and it has installed the Android and iOS on the same ID, and you can see these are the IDs which already has been configured. Once done, go back, open the browser again, and this automatically registered your this. Click on next. We know the last step is we need to add a Firebase core inside our project, which is a package to run all the commands. So let's copy it, go back over here. You can simply inside the pubspec.yml, you can find the latest package, but recommended way is use this command, flutter pub add Firebase core, hit enter. Okay, you can see Firebase core with the latest version has been added. So at the last, you can click on this pub get, or you can run flutter pub get, update the dependencies, and that's it. We are connected with our Firebase, and to see if we are connected or not, you can see we already have a file which is a Firebase options. Go back to the browser, hit continue to console, and in here we are going to use the cloud Firestore, and over here inside this build method we have a Firestore database, and also we are going to use the authentication. So we have both options over here. Open the Firestore, click on create database, and this is what we are going to learn in our next tutorial, in which we are going to learn how to store data inside the Firestore. We're going to use our sign up screen to collect all the data from user, and we are going to store the data inside our Firestore. We will learn what is Firestore and how the queries work inside the Firestore, what is collection, what is document, and also we are going to learn the comparison with the Firestore and normal SQL, which most of the people are familiar with. So at last, just for the confirmation, when you click on this project overview, you can see we have two apps which are connected with our Flutter login application. The one is the Android and second one is an iOS. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you learned something new. If you learned something new, please like the video. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about latest updates. Thank you for watching. Take care. Allah Hafiz.